for ably presenting it to this House. Mr. Speaker, the first time I read about this trial in the Volta region, I dismissed it because I believed that it was one of those speculations that might be put out there. Only for me to begin hearing from other colleague members of parliament that it's actually an issue that was going to take place in the Volta region. It sounded very interesting to me because I wondered, and I just asked myself, trial, how do you try such a deadly and unthinkable disease that we have all prayed against on humans and in no other country but in Ghana, where fortunately, God has protected us. We have prayed and prayed and it hasn't happened. We are now coming to try it on human beings. Have we finished trying it on rats, mice, and chimpanzees? Which many a times we know that is used for such trials, have we finished? That we are coming here, no information, no communication, no involvement, and we are going to try it on humans. For God's sake, are we inviting the virus into this country, or is it just research? Mr. Speaker, much as we might not know what the interest is of those who are actually going to do this, should we allow our people, should we sit here as representatives of the people and let them be tried with this simply because of 200 Ghana cedis and a mobile phone when we do not know the outcome? Mr. Speaker, the issue is an issue that when you look at it carefully, you just wonder, to what level we are reducing ourselves. Even if we have the structures, even if we have all the amenities, we have all the people, I don't believe that we should give our people out to such a thing, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, in conclusion, I just wish to say that we shouldn't suspend it. It should be stopped, not in Ghana here. It should be done somewhere else. If they want to do it in Ghana, they should do it in the laboratories with mice, rats, and chimpanzees, but not with human beings. Mr. Speaker, thank you very much for the time given.